So
here we stand in front of your house, just like we've done so many nights before, except very different, very, very different tonight. For tonight, Calvin, I see. Tonight we stand here as a couple.
Yes, Ed Stevens, that we do.
It's great, you know, it's exciting, because, you know, for non-couples, this right here marks the end of the road, you know, the end of the evening. But for us, that's old school, because for us, we're a couple and the night has just begun.
What do you mean by that exactly?
I should come inside.
Good night, Ed.
Good night. Whoa, hey, whoa, hang on. Did you say come in, Ed, but in a strange accent? Like a Ukrainian accent, perhaps?
Oh, I said good night, Ed.
Hold up. Okay, I see. Look, see, I think you're failing to grasp the concept of old school. Now, when you say, okay, good night, Ed, that's kicking it old school. Okay, now were you to say, come in, Ed, well, that'd be new school. Time to start kicking in new school.
Can we be serious for a second?
I'm serious. I'm dead serious. Never been more serious about anything in my life.
Tonight was absolutely perfect. And I want to remember it just as it is.
Okay. I guess I understand. Can I come in now, please? Kicking it old school.
I'm in the sky tonight.
So that's it? That's all you're gonna tell me? That's all there is to tell. You know, you amaze me.
Why?
3 years of walking down the street talking about Ed. 3 years, Carol. That's like over 1,000 days, a very significant chunk of our lifespan. You finally hook up with the guy, and you tell me nothing? That's unacceptable,
Molly.
I mean, you gotta tell me something, you know, anything. Just the tiniest detail, like, what kind of underwear does he wear? Let me guess. Boxers with a rubber duck motif.
I didn't see his underwear.
The man wears invisible underwear.
Molly, he walked me home. We said our goodnights. We went our separate ways. That's it, I swear.
You are absolutely 100% positive that you guys didn't do it.
Yes, for God's sakes, I think I would know.
Okay. All right, so answer me this. Hypothetically, if you had done it, how do you think it would have been?
Somehow I can't imagine Ed and Mike having this conversation.
Oh. Tell me more, did she put up a fight?
Ha, 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 very funny, Kinnicky. You know, on any other day, I would find that extremely irritating. Not today, my friend, for today, nothing can knock me off my golden perch of bliss.
You're gonna talk like that from now on?
I feel I've earned the right, my friend. I feel I've earned the right. You know, 3 years of Carol Vesey insanity, it's finally paid off.
3 years of Carol Vesey insanity? You couldn't even get into her house or live in her
pants. Michael! She's just saving a little something for later, you know what I'm saying? I'm cool with it.
Oh, sure you are. So how about Frankie? What are you gonna do about Frankie?
Nothing I can do. She's gone.
Oh, already?
Yeah, she's gone. She left. And we said our goodbyes at the party. She's off to Houston.
Wow, that must have been rough.
It was, you know, I mean, it was... You know, Frankie is, you know, she's amazing, right? I didn't want to start this whole thing with, not today. You know, today is not a day to dwell on the past. Today is a day to focus on the future, my friend.
A far distant future, like the year 2079 when you finally have sex with Carol Vesey.
Michael, just because we...
I knocked you out of your golden perch of bliss.
No one knows who she is, what her name.
Good morning, Stucky Bo.
You drunk?
Nah, man, I'm doing Robin Williams in Good Morning, Vietnam.
Hey, is that the one where he's the doctor with the clown nose? Because that was genius.
Shirley! Yo, Shirley, what in the world?
Good morning, Eli.
Please tell me I'm suffering from a temporary mental disorder which causes me to see 3 dozen tasty-looking pies, which in fact says pies does not exist.
No, Eli, these pies are very real.
Well, what are they doing here?
I bought them.
Why? Shirley, we lucky if we go through 2 pies a week.
I got an excellent deal.
Oh, you did, huh? But what are we gonna do with these?
We could have a celebrity pie eating contest. Just picture it. 3 dozen of today's hottest stars wolfing down pies for charity. Who can we get? Shirley, get me Howie Long on the phone.
Shirley, get rid of these pies.
But they're so apple-y.
Shirley.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Pies.
Got it covered.
Hello?
Good morning, Mr. Stevens.
Oh, good. Have we?
Edward, say hello to Miss Beverly Germain, or as I like to call her, Super Frankie.
I'm sorry?
I found you a new law partner.
You're a lawyer?
Before this, I worked at Photomat, but I like to try new things.
Excuse
us. Bosco, you are very, very welcome, but just so you know, she's got an 8-year-old kid at home, so caveat emptor, if you hear what I'm saying.
What's the matter with you?
Don't you want a new partner? If I had a nickel for every time I heard you say you'd be lost without Frankie, I would have like 4 nickels.
All right, look, I'll tell you what, you really want to help? Go ahead, set up some interviews with actual lawyers.
Actual lawyers. Interesting.
You know what? Better still, see if anyone's willing to come down and work on a trial basis. That way I'll be really able to see if we can work together. What's the matter?
Well, I don't really want to help you. I just wanted to stare at Super Frankie.
Yeah.
It's not too late, Nance. We can just get in the car and go back home.
Don't even think about it. We're getting a dog.
I don't want a dog.
Of course you want a dog.
I think you have me confused with you.
Possible. You are large and goofy, whereas I am wee and adorable.
Seriously, honey, dogs are so much work. Can't we just get a hamster?
It's not hamster, it's hamster. There's no P in the word.
Right, whatever. So that's yes to a hamster?
You must be the Burtons. Hey, welcome to Gideon Mandel's Doggy Paradise. Come on up.
Oh, my God, they're so cute.
Yes, I've got all sorts of wonderful fur babies to choose from. So what are you looking for?
I don't know, Nance. What kind of fur baby are we looking for?
Gosh, I don't even...
Big or small, dog or bitch?
I guess maybe a bitch?
It's all right to say it. That's the proper term for a girl.
How about biatch? Is that acceptable?
Ignore him. Hello, puppy. Oh, who's this little one?
Oh, that's Butch.
Butch the bitch. What is she, a lesbian?
You are a silly man, aren't you? Butch is a boy.
Oh, he's adorable. Look at him, Mike.
How much for Butch?
For this perfect, healthy, 100% purebred wire-haired terrier, $1,000 even.
Seriously? I can get one just like it at the pet store for $150.
Mike, not likely, Dr. Burton. You won't find a dog of Butch's lineage just anywhere.
Lineage? Come on, I'm trying to buy a dog. Not the Prince of Wales. $500.
That'll only get you the half that poops. I suggest you spring for the whole dog.
Come on, Mike, let's just do it. I love him.
Yeah, to credit.
Hey.
Hi, Butchie. He's so cute. His name is Butch.
His name's Willie.
What?
Why should we let that weird-ass breeder name our dog? I want to name my own dog.
Honey, I like Butch.
Hey, Willie.
Oh, God. All right, let's compromise. We'll call him Willie Butch.
I can live with that.
You people are insane.
Hey, look at this new doggy. Hello, hey. New doggy. Nice work, you guys. Hey, son. Hey, Mom. Yeah. Hey, Nancy. Hey, Carol.
Hi.
Is that weird for everybody?
Yeah, kinda. Nice shot.
Thanks. Hey, Carol.
Yeah.
You know Neil Patrick Harris?
Doogie Howser.
Yeah, Doogie Howser.
I love him.
Yeah, he's great. So you think when Neil Patrick Harris goes into a party and he meets someone, he says, hi, I'm Neil Patrick Harris, or you think he just says, hi, I'm Neil Harris?
I don't know.
But he just says, hi, I'm Neil Harris.
Yeah. Why is this so awkward?
Oh, it's awkward. It's awkward. A little bit awkward. Yeah, it's awkward. But you know what? I think that's fine. I think that's normal. We're undergoing a transition after all, so I think it's normal.
So what do we do? I want to feel normal. But if we act too normal, we won't feel... coupley, and if we act coupley, then we won't feel normal, so...
That's a good point. Here's what I say we do. We tackle this whole thing head on. Head on, you know? And because of that, I'm hereby inviting you out on a date.
A date?
That's right, a date. A date. A real date. Not like last night, but a real date. A formal date to help kick off our relationship in style. I'll pick you up tomorrow night. What do you say? I mean, it'll be fun. It'll be great. We'll have a great time. We'll know how to act. We've both been on dates before, right? So, what do you think?
Yes. Okay.
Okay, good. Okay, good. This is gonna be awesome.
Okay, I like this.
Okay.
Okay.
So I'll see you tomorrow night.
Yes.
Right, okay.
Definitely.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, ow.
Sorry.
It's okay. I think we need a way to signal each other if we're gonna go in for a kiss.
Semaphore flags.
Sounds good.
Oh, Mike, there's a poop under the chair.
What me?
I'll clean it up, but I want to see you start disciplining Willie Butch.
It's too late.
What do you mean?
And you have to yell at him right when he's pooping, otherwise it doesn't sink in.
Well, that's not what the training book says.
Yeah, well, it says right here in the stuff we got from the vet that, where's the pooping info? Come on, pooping info. What the hell, Nancy? Do you see this?
What?
This note from the vet, did you read it?
Oh, I don't know. What's it say?
Dog is most likely part wire-haired terrier, but not purebred, is indicated by tapering of snout and curvature of tail.
What?
Well, we got a bum dog, that's what. I don't believe this.
Well, that can't be right. Gideon Mandel.
I knew I didn't trust that bastard. $1,000? I paid for the caviar of dogs, and he sold us a can of Starkist of dogs. I'm calling Ed. I'm gonna sue.
No, honey, you can't. Willie Butch, no poo! No poo!
It's unbelievable. You called the breeder yet?
No, I wanted to talk to you first. What should we do?
Well, okay, we should start, but actually, Mr. Henderson, say you were my partner. How would you recommend we handle this case?
Well, I suppose we could visit the breeder and intimidate him into giving Dr. Burton his money back.
Mm-hmm. You'd be comfortable doing this?
Certainly.
Let me see a little.
A little what?
Intimidation.
Right now?
Please.
Oh, okay. Who should I intimidate?
Dr. Burton.
You, sir, have committed a fraud. Refund our money, or there will be serious consequences.
I'm not intimidated.
Do you have any idea who you're dealing with?
Still not intimidated.
Told you that you resemble a young Cary Grant. That is, of course, if Cary Grant had been a black man in a wheelchair.
Please tell me you didn't buy any more pies.
I didn't buy more pies.
You bought more pies?
Yes, a lot more.
Shirley, I told you to return the ones we already had.
I got a better deal.
You got a better deal?
Yes, the pie lady gave me an even steeper discount than I got on the first batch. At this price, the pies were well nigh irresistible.
Who in the hell is this pie lady? What is she, some kind of pie hypnotist? Yo, you know what? You need to get homegirl in here for a sit down.
I will contact homegirl immediately.
Hey, listen, Sparky, you really gotta help me set up for tonight. Which level of lighting you think is most romantic? This? 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 Or this? What do you think about this?
Get your hand off my thigh.
I like this. This is good, right?
It's fantastic.
Salesman, what do you think about this shirt, huh? What do you think about this bad boy?
No way.
Hawaiian shirts are in.
Yeah, you look like Mr. Furley.
Yeah.
Where are you taking her anyway?
Maison Grenouille.
That's it?
Yeah, it's it. It's the best place in town.
Yeah, but you can't go right to dinner. You need an icebreaker first.
What?
You know, an activity, something to loosen you up. You ever watch those dating shows? They don't just go out to eat. They go skydiving or play high liar.
Take fencing lessons.
Breaks the ice.
I need to break the ice there, pal. We've been friends for years.
I think you're making a huge mistake.
Oh, I'll be fine there, Lefty. Here, what do you think about this shirt? Is this something?
Well, I'd love to continue this conversation, but I'm afraid I'm not homosexual.
How's your lobster?
It's great.
Mine too.
Yeah.
It's great. Hey, say, you think when A lobster prays to God. He envisions God as just like this really big, huge lobster in the sky.
Probably not the sky, no.
Why not? Oh, right. Lobsters need water to breathe. Of course, we're talking about an omnipotent lobster. He could probably breathe anywhere he wants. Do you think?
Masks down. Hung out. She fits.
You comfortable?
Uh-huh.
Can I get your beverage?
No, I'm good.
Really? Because, you know, I got this hip new kind of flavored vodka. You know, it's supposed to taste like tequila. Begging the question there, why wouldn't you just, you know, drink tequila, you know? Mm. Question for which there is truly no good answer.
I had a really good time tonight.
Sure.
But I'm a little tired.
It's only 9:30.
I should go home.
Because you're tired.
Sorry.
No, please, you know. No, when you're tired, you're tired.
So I'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Sure. Okay. Thanks. Good night.
On guard.
Oh, yes, on guard.
Right. So, Fred, where'd you go to law school?
Went to Stanford. It's a great, great time.
Oh, wow. Huh. I'm impressed. It's a fantastic school.
Hey, best in Connecticut.
In?
Stamford, not Stanford.
Oh. Well, what about Yale? Yale's in Connecticut.
Yeah, six of one, half dozen the other. They're both terrific.
Say hello to the world's cutest dachshund. This is Mr. Bojangles.
Actually, we're attorneys.
Oh, so perhaps a Doberman instead.
I love the lawyer jokes. You know, my favorite is the one, how did the... Yeah, I'm blanking, but it's something about a shark and professional courtesy or... something.
Okay. Mr. Mandel, I represent Dr. and Mrs. Burton. You sold them a dog recently. Now, the Burtons are seeking compensatory damages in the amount of $850 because you misrepresented the dog you sold them.
Mr. Mandel, you represented a quality of dog that turned out not to be the quality of dogs that you sold the Burtons. So they'd like $850 back to compensate for that misrepresentation.
I don't know what all this Broadway ballyhoo is about, but if the Burtons are really unhappy, bring back Butch and I'll give them back their money.
Great, wrap it up and we'll take it.
Actually, my clients would prefer to keep the dog and get the refund.
Wrap it up and we'll take it to the garbage and throw it out. Mm-hmm. Our clients want to keep the dog and get a refund.
Sorry, no doggy can do.
Why not?
Because once you let one doggy lick himself, then they'll all start doing it.
You know something? That is so true. We had this little Pomeranian named Gus, and I'm telling you, that little guy used to go to town down there anytime he...
Fred!
Sorry. It's not a story for mixed company.
I won't give them the money and the dog.
Fine. Then I guess we'll speak again soon.
So, anybody up for lunch at Bennigan's?
You figured out what you're gonna say to her yet?
Yeah, I'm gonna say, lady, take your damn pies back.
You want me to handle the negotiations?
Negotiations?
That's how the chick on CNN says it.
Here she comes, Dust. Hit it.
I better stay. You don't have a lot of street smarts for an African-American.
I'm looking for Shirley. She said there's a problem?
Oh, I'm sorry, baby, but there won't be no Shirley today. So you step it up to some major league pitching now. Be a little harder to get across the Mendoza line with Eli Cartwright. God is the third on the mound.
So, what's the problem?
Wait, what'd you say your name was again?
Jennifer Young.
Jenny Fair. Don't be so coy, Jenny Fair. The number 83 is the problem. I mean, we as humans are designed to buy and sell things in certain increments, twos, threes, six, even a dozen. 83.
Come on now. That number 83 sounds like someone is taking advantage of my little Shirley, if you ask me.
How many pies do you want to keep?
But the customers love them. 7.
Great. I'll take 76 back. Here's your money. Where are my pies?
You think Willie Butch understands that I'm a human, or do you think he just thinks I'm a giant dog who's really talented?
Why would he think you're really talented?
Well, he sees me walking on two legs, speaking English. Earlier, he saw me operating Windows 98. I think I'm impressing the hell out of him.
Let me ask you something. I'm not a hideous-looking man, am I?
Eddie, what are you talking about? You're adorable.
Sounds like somebody didn't get any schmoodle the other night.
Schmoodle? Is that what guys are calling it these days?
Oh, yeah, you can pretty much say anything there. Somebody didn't get any flabidity fluts. See?
I married you. Why?
As painful as this is to admit, little Dr. Phil over there is actually right. I sure didn't get any flabbity schmoodle the other night.
Flabbity fluts.
See, why would Carol want to stay over?
Eddie, you and Carol together, you know, it takes some getting used to. It's like when McDonald's introduced the McDLT. Nobody knew what the hell to do right away.
Hot side hot, cool side cool. That was confusing.
If I'm not mistaken, I believe the McDLT failed.
I think what Nancy's trying to say is that men are from Mars and women are from Venus.
No, that's not what I'm trying to say.
I know, but a fact like a dope will shorten the conversation.
No, maybe this thing just isn't going to work, you know? It's like we're not clicking somehow.
Eddie, you and Carol spent the last 3 years metaphorically and literally dressing up as knights in shining armor for each other. Honey, that's a lot to live up to.
Yeah, I guess so.
Everything will be solved once you two finally get together and shalooby-doo. That one doesn't really work.
It's too much like Scooby-Doo.
Yeah?
I need to know what the heck you're doing with Ed.
What?
Nancy told me you didn't stay over at his house.
Why is this everybody's business?
Hey! Hey, I have had to sit through 3 years of boring psychological stuff. Don't even think for a second that you were gonna cut me out of the juicy part.
Look, I didn't stay over at his house. It's no big deal, okay?
Yes, it is a big deal. Ed is a great guy. The two of you are finally together. You should be doing it like badgers.
Badgers?
I meant funnies.
I can't.
Why not?
Because.
Because why?
Because it won't live up to the hype.
Hype? Well, what hype?
The hype, the expectations. 3 years of ups and downs and ins and outs and the waiting, my God, and all culminates in this one moment. It's too much. I can't take it. Do you care to expound?
Yeah.
When you put it like that.
Carol, this is the one. For once in your life, stop thinking.
But what if
and
you said...
And stop talking. It'll be fine. Trust me.
Hey.
Hey.
Bowling?
Yeah, bowling. Why wouldn't I? I can bowl anytime I want. And let's face it, that's the real reason I bought the alley.
It's not the reason you bought the bowling alley.
It isn't?
No. The reason you bought the bowling alley is because that night you came to Stuckeyville and you and I stood by the pond and we did this.
That and the fact I can bowl anytime I want.
Come with me. I have a surprise for you.
This is delicious fried chicken.
It's a family recipe.
Really? If I'd known you could make fried chicken like this, I would have come to town out of the blue, tracked you down, and pursued you relentlessly for 3 years.
I got it at the deli.
But it's always a family recipe.
It is. Just not my family's.
Ha! Nice. Very honest.
Ed.
Yeah?
I'm really sorry about the other night.
What about the other night?
At your house.
Sorry, I don't know what you're talking about.
It's me.
Okay, all right. I know what you're talking about. You don't have to apologize. You don't have to apologize.
I think I was just jitters, you know?
It's fine, really. It's fine. It is. It's fine. I understand.
Ed.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I'm thinking right now?
How does arena football stay in business?
No.
When will the Cola Wars come to an end?
Uh-uh.
Why would Newt Gingrich's parents name a baby Newt?
This is gonna go on forever, right?
It's who I am.
No, I was thinking that whereas the other night I was feeling very jittery, right now I'm feeling very, very unjittery.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, then, you know what I'm thinking right now?
What's the capital of North Dakota? I am not as good at this as you are.
I'm thinking, come with me.
Huh?
What's that?
Oh.
Bismarck. You're sure about this, right? I mean, because I don't want you to do anything you're not sure about.
Well, Ed.
Actually, you know what? Forget it. Let's not even discuss this. I was being polite, because it's a formality, I think. It's a mere formality. You know, because I think you're sure, right? I mean, you're sure. Of course you're sure. You're sure. You're sure. You're sure. You're smiling. Why are you smiling? You're smiling. You're smiling because you're sure. You're smiling because you're sure. You're sure. You're sure. She's sure! Ha-ha! Oh.
What?
What if I'm not sure? I am, I'm sure.
It's kind of awkward, isn't it?
Oh, no. Not awkward at all.
What if we don't...
Saying it was bad?
I'm saying it wasn't amazing.
How could it not be amazing?
I don't know, Molly. It's like you have all the ingredients for the world's greatest Thanksgiving dinner, and you cook all the food exactly the way you should, but for some reason the turkey comes out dry and the gravy's all starchy.
Have you two ever actually tried to use gravy? Because I hear it can really
You're whapping me now?
Molly, this isn't Sex in the City. It's my life, and it's falling apart.
Okay, your life is not falling apart.
It's easy for you to say. Carol, stop thinking. Carol, don't talk so much. Carol, it'll all be fine. Trust me. Just go and have some really bad sex with Ed. Because that's what your already shaky relationship needs.
Okay, I never said that last part.
It was implied.
Oh, hey, by the way, it's Sex and the City. You said Sex in the City.
All right, go ahead.
What did you say?
What could I say? I said it was really amazing.
Even though it wasn't amazing.
Right, it was completely unamazing, but she said that was amazing, so I said that was really amazing.
Wow.
Yeah.
This is one of my patients gave me this little pamphlet he got in Hong Kong. It's kind of a gag gift, but I've been trying a few of the moves.
Guy, you and I both know my performance in the sack is not an issue.
How would I know that?
It's not about technique, okay? It's about chemistry. It's about chemistry.
Just go back. I'm still not comfortable with that other sentence.
How could it be after 3 years of anticipation, nay, 20 years of anticipation, we get together and... Dud.
I don't mean to harp on this, but can we just be clear that I have no actual knowledge base of you in bed?
What's the matter with you?
I just don't like that hanging there. It kind of gives me the heebie-jeebies.
Hey, what are you talking about?
I was just saying...
Just talking about the case. Come on, let's get going.
Tell me later.
Yep.
Think about getting one of those Mike Tyson face tattoos, you know? Just kind of shake things up a little. Now, I've been experiencing some ennui.
Damn, this woman know how to make pie.
Maybe I should legally change my name to Gordy for a while.
We're out of pies.
Are you kidding? We went through 7 pies in 3 days?
They're selling like hotcakes, except they're pies. They are pies with the selling power of hotcakes. It's the best of all worlds.
I want you to get Jennifer Young Pie Lady Extraordinaire on the line. I want to order another dozen of pies. And that's 12 pies, a dozen, not 83.
Roger that.
Perfect. Why do they call them hotcakes anyway? They're not hot. They're not cakes.
Yes, they are.
They are. Man, I thought I had the beginning of a great stand-up back there. Damn.
Is it possible, Mr. Mandel, that somehow a mistake was made and the Burton's dog is not a full-bred wire-haired terrier?
Hey, you're dealing with dogs in heat. When it comes time to mate, they don't much care whether they're partnered with a dog of their own breed or a 68 Impala.
But you do keep the wire-haired terriers together.
Oh, yes, we certainly all breed.
Hey,
are you aware that the mother of the Burton's
10 bucks if you call it Judge Sally.
I never saw anything like that.
I'm in the middle of a case. I'm in the middle of your case. 10 bucks,
That's correct.
And what did you offer to do?
I told the Burtons that if they were unhappy with the dog, they should return it for a full refund.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Mr. Stevens.
Yes, sir. Mr. Mandel, do you know a man named John Campletaro? Well, you don't have to look at your lawyer. Mr. Mandel, you know whether you know him.
Yes, he owns a puppy farm.
Puppy farm sells dogs to pet stores. Generally, their dogs are lower quality than those of our breeders, correct?
Yes.
Is it true that you purchase some of these lower-bred dogs from Campletaro's puppy farm to sell as your own, in addition to selling your own breeds? I'm more than happy to have Mr. Campletaro come in and testify if need be.
Yes, but I only sell a few of those, and I always tell the customer and charge accordingly.
Always. Interesting. How many times in the past year have you received complaints from people who believe they're buying a top-bred dog only to discover they're buying a dog of lower breeding?
I can't tell you.
I tracked down 16 in the past year alone. I'm guessing there were more.
So what? I always offered a full refund.
And of the 16 I tracked down, I wonder how many took you up on that offer. None, Mr. Mandel. Zero.
Well, I guess they got attached to their dogs. Not my fault.
They got attached. They got attached. You know, they do get attached, don't they? Which is why you always wait a full week before offering the refund, so they'll get attached and won't take you up on that offer. Isn't that true, Mr. Mandel? Nothing further. Thank you, Sally.
Did you just call me Sally?
No.
All rise. Be seated.
Mr. Mandel. I believe that you are intentionally passing off dogs from Campletaro's puppy farm as your own, and did so in the Burton case. This court orders you to pay the Burtons $850.
Don't lie to
me. Damages.
Jenny Fair, maker of pies.
Shirley tells me you want to place an order?
Oh, no, I don't want to. I have to. My lunch and my dinner crowd have been picking up since I've been serving them little devils.
How many do you want?
I just want a dozen.
I'm sorry.
Whoa, where are you going?
I'm selling in blocks of 100.
What?
See, we humans, we're designed to buy in increments, and these pies are selling in increments of 100.
So what you're saying is, if I don't buy 100 pies, you're not going to sell me any pies?
I'm Monty Hall. You're a contestant. Behind door number one is 100 pies. Behind door number two is 0 pies. Behind door number three is I start selling my pies to your competitors.
What am I going to do with 100 pies?
Freeze them, thaw them, sell them.
Yo, that is pie blackmail.
Old Eli Cartwright Goggins III is on the mound now. I'm just struggling to get my pretty little self over the Mendoza line.
All right, Miss Jennifer Young. You got old Eli this time. All right, give me 100 pies. And don't go pulling them out all slow, either. 1, 2, 3. That's like a dude with a slow home run trot.
5, 6.
I told you you should let me handle the negotiations.
How about I put my shoe up your butt?
Well, how would you even do that?
I'll use my hand.
Okay. 8, 9.
You've been bowling a lot lately.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I love bowling. Straightforward. You know, roll the ball, knock down the pins. Conflict and resolution in every frame.
Ed,
Yeah.
The other night?
No. You don't have to say it. We both know it.
Oh.
This isn't working, is it?
Not swimmingly, no.
Yeah.
You know, when I was in fifth grade, there was a stingray bicycle in the window of the bike shop. Gold banana seat, black pom-poms on the handlebars. I wanted that bike so badly, it killed me.
And?
And after some very serious and persistent begging, my father finally got it for me, and I was thrilled. When I got it home and took it out for that very first ride, I kind of realized it was just an ordinary bike.
I'm the bike? I'm the bike that didn't live up to your expectations?
No. I'm the bike.
Carol. Do you think it's possible that you and I were just meant to be friends?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, there's a problem.
What?
The problem is I don't think I can be friends with you.
Why?
Because I already got plenty of friends. Said it never
break your heart now. How did you learn? What? You believed in the words and all that they meant. Oh, but love is not some popular song filled with empty sentiment.
Cynical, darling, I know how it feels. You took it to heart, to set on the screen. Oh, but love is not just playing a part in some very scripted scene. That's what passes for love.
Guess what I did today?
What's that?
I taught Willie Butch to talk.
Is that right?
Yep, I did. Check it out. Hey, Willie Butch. Talk to me, okay? Talk.
Hey, Mike, listen. Seriously, aren't you glad that you got me? I'm so cute and adorable. Hey,
tell him not to call me Mike.
Well, why can't I call you Mike?
It's not appropriate. I'm your master.
What should I call you then? Can I call you Daddy?
What do you think? Can I call you Daddy?
Call me Dr. Burton.
Hey, let me call you Daddy. Well, stop pooping in the house.
Well, in that case, come on over here, son. Oh, hey, he's piddling right on me.
Oh, Willie, what'd you know?
Oh, that's easy. He's lying right to my face.
Is there poop? You didn't say piddle? Yeah,
that's implied.
Whew. What the hell was that?
I don't know.
Remember the whole maybe we were just meant to be friends thing?
Yeah.
We are never to speak of that again.
Never.
Do you understand? It is forbidden.
Yes, I do. I think we just took care of that pretty well.
Why was this time like this time and last time was like last time?
I don't know. I don't know. I guess this time we had nothing to lose.
Mm.
That night, Googled how to satisfy your woman.
Mm-hmm. So, did you say we're one and one?
Oh, yeah.
You want to make it 2 out of 3?
Let's go best out of 7. 100.